musical Dreamgirls has put two different Jennifers in the spotlight. All of my life, I've been fooled. Newcomer Jennifer Hudson plays singer Effie White in the movie version, but another Jennifer, Jennifer Holliday, originated the role on Broadway. Both on stage and on screen, the character Effie White is pushed out of the spotlight and out of her relationships, despite her extraordinary singing voice. Come on, sweet baby, come on. Today, Jennifer Holliday, who was left out of the movie, says her own life echoes Effie's.
I am Effie. It's not, no, I'm not the essence of Effie. I am Effie.
Holliday has been struggling to emerge from Effie's shadow ever since she played the role in 1982. For 3 years, adoring standing room only crowds would come to hear her belt out the musical's trademark song. And I am telling you, I'm not going. She was just 21 years old. Times are showing. There's just
no way. There's no way. Let me read something. If the curtain didn't fall, the audience would probably cheer Jennifer Holliday until dawn. That's what the New York Times wrote about you after opening night. How did you feel you did? You think you did okay?
I think I never knew. That I think I never quite understood what they see from the stage, what they saw.
What they saw was Holliday's Tony Award winning performance. What they couldn't see was that offstage, Jennifer Holliday and Effie White were becoming one and the same, struggling with weight problems and feelings of rejection. Holliday gained 100 pounds in 1 year and became more and more isolated.
I could eat a box of Popeye's chicken with a liter of Coca-Cola and never miss a beat. Just eating, just the food was just so joyous. It was the only joy.
She was a long way from her middle-class upbringing outside Houston, with her mother, who was a school teacher, and her father, a minister. Holliday was barely out of high school when a scout heard her singing in the church choir and asked her to try out in New York City.
And I said, well, first of all, we have to ask my mama if I can come. And he got his aunt, who was a praying woman, and to talk to my mother, and told her, say, well, if you send up here to audition, she'll stay with us in Brooklyn. We'll take her. She'll come home. She'll come to church with us. She'll never go anywhere.
And mom said?
Mom said yes. And I auditioned that day and got hired that day.
She won a role in the musical Your Arms Too Short to Box with God. But soon, famed director Michael Bennett, coming off the huge success of A Chorus Line, asked her to work on his new musical, Dreamgirls. During rehearsals, actors fine-tuned their own roles.
What about me?
In its original form, Effie disappears at the end of the first act.
Yeah, I said, well, I don't know anything about being a star or famous on Broadway or anything like that, but I do know that the fact that Effie doesn't come back sucks. That's all I know.
The battles between Holliday and Bennett while creating Effie White became legendary.
Now, did you get fired or did you quit? What happened there?
I said I quit. He said he fired me. I quit. But he called me, though I ain't call him, to come back. So let's who want to go with that?
Jennifer Holliday returned to Dreamgirls, and the character Effie White returned in the musical second act. Holliday says her argument stemmed from a deep connection she felt toward the overlooked Effie White.
Effie has to win something. She can't just become nothing. No one's going to understand why she couldn't make something of her life.
And no one understood that even with the cheering crowds and rave reviews, Jennifer Holliday was lonelier than she'd ever been.
Everyone knew the voice, but no one really knew me.
After 3 years, Holliday left the show, but Effie wouldn't leave her. And I'm Telling You I'm Not Going remains her only hit. She says no one was interested in anything else.
That hurt?
Yeah, hurt a lot. You know, hurt.
How'd you deal with that?
I think that got bigger. actually.
So? Really?
Yeah, I think so. I think because instead of saying to yourself, I'm going to go on a diet and I'm going to show them I'm going to be beautiful, whatever, you kind of go, okay, well, if they don't want me and nobody appreciates what I do, you know, I'm just going to, you know, stay the way I am and love me for who I am.
On her 30th birthday, she took an overdose of pills.
I actually thought my life was over anyway, because I basically had gotten so big. I was well over 330 pounds. I had no record company. I had lost everything, struggling so much that I just, you know, I was like, I don't think that there's any need to stay here.
She was diagnosed with clinical depression, a chemical imbalance in the brain that's treated with medication and therapy.
I have suffered with clinical depression for over 16 years.
And soon, she began speaking out about her suicide attempt and mental health issues.
And what I have been able to do in these years is to function with my depression.
My whole outlook on life began to change. And then that's when I got help with the weight loss. And I had the gastric bypass surgery.
She dropped nearly 200 pounds.
Think about the sun.
And in the late 90s, Jennifer Holliday was back playing the choir director on Ally McBeal.
With the power and the glory.
But when the show went off the air, other offers didn't come. Still, the role struck a chord.
You sing in the church choir. Is that
right?
Sing
in the church choir here.
That's got to be intimidating.
No, I think, well, first of all, I know how to blend.
She joined the Abyssinian Baptist Church in Harlem.
And it has been one of the greatest experiences that I've had in these years of living.
But her renewed faith was tested when word came that Dreamgirls was being made into a movie. Holliday yearned for the acknowledgement often given stage actors in motion picture remakes.
You still had some hopes that, hey, maybe I can play Effie in that.
Yeah, I thought that I might get a call just to get a call. I don't know what it would say, you know?
Did that call ever come?
No, never came. I couldn't believe it. I kept saying, they're not gonna even call me for anything, not even a cameo.
Of course, she wouldn't be the first Broadway actress to be snubbed. Julie Andrews was famously passed over for the movie version of My Fair Lady in favor of Audrey Hepburn.
I don't want no gold and no diamonds. I'm a good girl, I am.
Effie.
The producers of Dreamgirls have declined to comment on why Holliday was not offered a role.
Why would you even do something like this to me? I have nothing else but the legacy of Dreamgirls.
You saw the movie.
Mm-hmm.
Did you want to see it?
I did not want to see it.
Why'd you go?
Because everybody was going to ask me, had I seen it? So
you said, I better go see it.
I better go.
Holliday slipped into a matinee at a local theater.
I can't think of another way to ask this, but did you like it?
I thought that it was a good movie.
You want my love and soul.
What did you think about Jennifer Hudson's performance?
There's no way that I could say against what everyone saying that Jennifer Hudson is definitely good in this role.
Could love you forever.
All I could say though, for myself, I didn't look at it as this is not a great performance, this is a great performance, this is, I was like, this is our performance.
You saw yourself up there.
I saw myself up there.
Big smile, straight ahead, Jennifer!
When you see her getting all these accolades, the record contracts, the other movie deals are coming in, any resentment?
Believe it or not, I have no resentment for what she's getting in terms of those kind of things.
Working up, Jennifer!
Someone always gives someone else a leg up, and they make the money.
But there is one aspect of Jennifer Hudson's success that haunts Jennifer Holliday to this day.
She got to take Effie off, and I never got to take Effie off. I always had to be Effie. That destroys me more than anything else.
But if you have to be Effie, now's the time.
Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Jennifer Holliday. Come on!
Suddenly, the woman with no publicist, no manager, and no agent has a full dance card.
It has been 25 years since the play of Dreamgirls.
And she says she'll keep singing the song that started it all, which she now considers words to live by.
And I am telling you, I'm not going.
I sing it with a greater source of determination, a greater source of love. So yes, I am definitely singing, and I'm telling you, I'm not going like never before, like never before.